Hello everybody, and thank you all for watching again. How to make an indestructible $5 training plane, episode number 4, where we're going to build in the body and the motor mount slash firewall. And step 1, the supplies that you're going to be needing is 80 centimeter long, 2x2, or actually 18 mil by 80 mil, but 2x2 is much more easy. That is super strong and stiff and doesn't bend and flex. You also need a 35 centimeter long, 5 centimeter wide wooden plank or wooden board that is multiplex or triplex and is also very stiff and strong. And you're gonna cut it in three different lengths and in 4 pieces, 2 times 5 by 5 centimeters. That's gonna be the motor mount and the support. Then a piece of 15 centimeters. This is gonna be the support for the main wing. And then a piece of 10 centimeters that is gonna be supporting the tail section. You also need 5 screws that are 2.5 centimeters long. And some wood glue, some wood clamps. And a screwdriver can always be handy. And of course, an ecotool. And that's all you need to make an indestructible body for your $5 training plane. The best plane to learn to fly, because it gives you the most seat time. And step 2, you need to make the body, but that's already done. That is right, simple 80 centimeter stick. So let's go to step 3 and make the motor mount. And the first step of your firewall is finding the center. So you mark it, you cross it, and when you found the center, you go to your motor that comes with a nice package with a motor mount and a pop adapter and fuse screws. So it's fully packed with accessories to make it one step that fits everything to make it super easy for you. Second step is finding the center with the motor mount, and you can place it in 2 ways. Some people like to place it this way, but if you are having to put the motor on an angle, then it makes a lot more sense to put the motor mount this way. The second step, if you found the center, is keeping it there, making sure that everything is nice and level. Some people like to mark it and then drill the holes, and then it still can be a little bit off. So my way of doing it is putting a screw in there. Now that the motor mount is held down by 2 screws, your shear is not going to move. Now you can easily drill open. Now I've placed 2 screws in those, and we are gonna remove the other 2 screws. So now we can drill those. In the next step, we are going to prep the main wing support, and that's actually just finding the center and drilling 2 holes from the 2 centimeters from the edge. That's pretty easy, pretty simple, straightforward. Let's get to the tail support that is 10 centimeters long. And again, you find the center, and then off the center, around 2 centimeters. You drill a hole so we can attach that to the body. In the next step, we are going to add all the pieces to the body, and the most easiest is the tail section. Let's start off with that first, and just need to make sure that everything is centered up and lined up. So I added a line all along the body, marking out the center, of course, and then it's just easy way of lining things up. Then we use some clamps to keep it in place and drill the hole. At this time, I like to add the screws and make sure that the tip just sticks out at the bottom. And then now we add wood glue towards the tail, and then screw the tail section in its place. Also make sure that the screws goes into the wood so that it's completely flat. There's one little piece of information that I forgot to tell you before adding the tail section, is that you have to look for the grains of the wood and make sure you drill from the top, compressing all the layers of wood together. Because if we were drilling sideways to this wooden stick in between the grains, it would just crack open and split open, and you would lose all the strength of the wooden stick. Motor mount design is going to be very simple, with the supports going to be sitting on top with the motor mount in front. So you need to make sure that everything is nice and level, and that your stick is completely level out. And now you need to mark it so I can find the center, so we can drill a hole with a screw that attaches to the body. Then I mark how big the stick is. That's 2x2, or well, 18 mil, then minus 9 millimeters. So I find this the center. We have to drill it one more time so we can put a screw inside the body. And I'm also going to tap out the hole a little bit so we don't get problems with the motor mount, and the screw will be sitting completely flush. Now the only thing that you have to do is find the center of your wooden stick and then drill one more hole. We already put the screw in with the point sticking out the rear. So now we can put some glue on the wooden stick and glue those 2 together. And then make sure you screw it down really nice and tight so that all the wood glue is spreading out the rear. Then we're gonna add a little bit more wood glue and a little bit more on top of the stick. And I always like to put it there and move it around a little bit, spreading out the wood glue, keeping it in place, making sure that everything is nice and level and lined out in the center. And in this case, we're just gonna use some wood clamps and then add some more wood glue just to fill up the gaps. And as the last thing, you'll be expecting us to put the main wing support already on top of the body and mount it nice and firm. But that step has to wait. because it's going to be the last step after we added the tail and the motor and perhaps landing gear. And that is all coming up in the next episode, where we also have to find the CG, and then we also going to add the main wing at the correct position after adding all the electronics and the tail section and perhaps landing gear. So please, I hope you subscribe for that if you're new to this channel, and click that notification bell so you will be notified when the video will be released. And this video also needs your support, and I really hope you give it a like. I can use that a lot and will be much appreciated. And I want to say goodbye, and I hope to see you next time.